Never forget that you did not do this by yourself. You come here today trailing the breath of the ancestors and the breath of the angels.
It was graduation day for more than 550 students at Spelman College in Atlanta, Georgia. The class of 2012 was proud of its achievements, but even more excited about the commencement speaker on Sunday, Oprah Winfrey. A commencement speech is a chance to share wisdom and experience with a wide audience.
But what qualities make a speech memorable and significant? Sarah Jedd is the Assistant Director for Communication Arts at UW-Madison. She's joining us Stan Live. Welcome.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi,
welcome.
Thanks.
What are some key elements to make a speech memorable, a commencement speech?
Well, I think the most successful commencement speeches are funny. They have at least one funny line. And I also think that a speech should be a little bit poignant, should leave the graduates with something to think about as they, you know, leave college and enter the real world.
Something like from personal experience,
yes,
you mean?
Yes, a life lesson.
Now, you know of what you speak because you were the commencement
yes.
speaker when you graduated from graduate school.
Yes, that's true, in 2009. And it was incredible to see my face on the Jumbotron at Kohl Center. It was really
cool.
How
much pressure was it, though?
It was a lot of pressure because you know that people are more concerned about their walk across the stage than they are about what the commencement speaker is saying. Mm-hmm. I mean, everybody likes the commencement speech, but you know, it's a selfish moment. You're thinking about yourself and your accomplishment and your parents and your family.
It's your big day.
Right.
Let's look at another memorable speech. This is Barbara Bush. Let's listen to this one.
Who knows? Somewhere out in this audience may even be someone who will one day follow in my footsteps and preside over the White House as the president's spouse, and I wish him well.
There's the comment.
That was
right.
a great one.
That's the best line.
So that's
the audience
what she
went
did
crazy.
Right.
Yeah,
the
they loved
line
it.
That,
right.
That everybody remembers.
And,
yes.
and still a message.
Right, right.
All right, we have another one here. Ellen DeGeneres.
Really, when I look back on it, I wouldn't change a thing. I mean, it was so important for me to lose everything because I found out what the most important thing is to be true to yourself. And ultimately, that's what's gotten me to this place. I don't live in fear. I'm free. I have no secrets. And I know I'll always be okay because no matter what, I know who I am.
Now, you would have expected Ellen to be funny, but she was actually much more poignant.
Right. And the beginning of the speech is just hilarious, uproariously funny. But by the end, she brings the audience into a really poignant moment. So, I mean, she's a pro. That's the perfect thing to do.
How much pressure is there to have that special moment?
I think there's a lot of pressure. I just met with the senior class president at UW who gave a fantastic commencement speech, and that he was, you know, really trying to find that one moment because he knew that the energy of the room depended on finding that one moment for his audience.
A lot of the college graduations are done, but high school graduations are still to come, so kids who are
right.
valedictorians and salutatorians, maybe that's what they want to be thinking about, is
right.
that one significant turning point moment in their life.
That they share with their audience. It's really important to talk about things that you have in common with the audience, an experience that you all had because you all went to the same school. People love to hear that.
So getting personal is not a bad thing.
No, it's perfect.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, and that leads beautifully into the commencement speech that went viral
right.
Immediately following his death. This is Steve Jobs, his commencement speech at Stanford University.
The past 33 years, I've looked in the mirror every morning and asked myself, if today were the last day of my life, would I want to do what I am about to do today? And whenever the answer has been no for too many days in a row, I know I need to change something. Remembering that you are going to die is the best way I know to avoid the trap of thinking you have something to lose. You are already naked. There is no reason not to follow your heart.
That's a powerful speech,
mm-hmm.
especially in light of what happened.
Right.
For people in the audience, what should you listen for if you know you're listening to a good speech?
Well, I think if you're listening to a really good speech, there's going to be something, an anecdote, a line, a message that really catches you, that you're going to remember maybe forever. I mean, I think that's the goal of the commencement speaker, is to give you this experience that's so memorable, you're always going to remember it when you think about your college or your high school or your graduate school career.
I remember mine vividly. It was Ted Koppel, and he got on the stage, and he addressed all the graduates, and he said, "Welcome to the School of Life."
That's great.
Yeah, and I think I said that on the air last mm-hmm. week. It's always stuck with me.
And apparently mine wasn't that memorable, because I don't remember who it was. I don't remember a line from it.
See, you should have listened to her.
Right.
I remember it was.
Well, great. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah,
a lot of
really
insight,
was.
And it was great to hear some of those speeches.
Yeah, great. Well, thanks.
Thanks for being with
Thank
us
you,
today.
Thank you, sir. Good
You're
to
welcome.
Meet you.